Hello there, all you amazing people. We are going to talk about growth of Linux. We are almost close to 5%. Whoa. And you see people making videos about, you know, Linux growing and stuff like that. This is going to be a really boring video. So just for the fact of that, subscribe, comment and like, and go on to Discord and suggest videos for me to make. But this is mostly just going to be us looking at this here, and it's going to be really boring because I'm going to basically explain why this means nothing. So let's just compare Windows with Linux. We are taking away Chrome OS, even though Chrome OS could be regarded a bit as Linux, but Chrome OS is a specific use case Linux for specific computers. I will go into unknown and Chrome OS, what we should do with those. So this is how it looks like. Let's zoom in a little bit here for you guys. This is what it looks like. 2003, we had, we've grown, or Linux has grown, not me, but I've been gotten fatter, but like, let's say about 2%, not 2%, but a good chunk over 1% in a year. So that means that if you want Linux to become 15%, it will take 10 years in the current growth rate, about 10 years. In about 10 years, computing as we know it is going to be turned upside down. More people are using tablets, handheld devices, more and more people running away from the traditional desktop. You know, the big ass desktop, laptops are still kind of used, but they are also going away, where people are favoring tablets and so on and so on. In 10 years time, my prediction is that most computing are being done on phones and tablets. It's only developers and really specific use case scenarios that we are going to use the good old desktops, like what we are looking at here, the desktop wins the market. So it's only us nerds that never go outside, maybe some few hardcore gamers and data scientists, developers, workstations that will be using desktop operating systems. So if you go in and we look at Android, maybe Chrome OS will go up a little bit, but Android, iOS, stuff like that, that will be taking over the market. And no, Android is not Linux. Android is not Linux. It's a fork of Linux. It's based on Linux, but it's not Linux. But this means nothing. This means nothing. Like, again, comparatively, you look at how big of a difference this is. Like, look, I don't know if I can highlight it. Look at the difference here. It's almost meaningless. I know if you're a fan of Linux, this is like, oh, but, you know, Linux used to be 3%. Here's the thing. I used to use Linux when it was under 1% of the desktop market. All of the advantages that Linux is today, Linux is still on the desktop 10, 15 years behind Windows and Mac OS in a lot of technologies. In the worst place, in the best place, they are 5 to 3 years behind. With things that you can't do on Windows, technologies that works on Windows and Mac OS that Linux just don't support, that desktop users want. This is as it gets. Will Linux go up and beat Mac OS? Will Linux beat Mac OS? This is what you should really ask yourself. If you're really good Linux nerd, I know, you know, let's go for the, you know, let's reach for the top. But, you know, we take things in chunks, you know, like that. I don't want to lose 1 ton of weight. I want to use like 10 kilograms at the time. So the biggest or closest competitor to Linux right now is Mac OS. Is Linux ever going to beat Mac OS? There is a really, really, really slim chance that is going to do that. You can see here it's almost 15%, and here it's like there's almost 10% difference. There's a really slim chance that it's going to happen. I would say like maybe a 10, 15% chance or 20% chance that Linux in the next 10 years is going to beat Mac OS as a desktop operating system. We're not talking handheld devices, if you want to believe Android, or we're not talking Chrome OS. We're talking good old standard Ubuntu, you know, all of these kind of things. I will give it like, if I'm being like really like what I think will happen, there will be like a 1 to 5% chance. If I'm being optimistic, 10 to 15% chance. But I don't think Linux is ever going to beat Mac OS. It's just not providing enough people with what they want. Mac OS, for Linux to beat Mac OS, it has to provide the same creature comforts, the same accessibilities, the same hardware accessibilities, the same software accessibilities. And I don't mean alternatives here, people. I don't mean alternatives. I mean the same software. When Linux can do that, they may have a chance, but that's not something you do in a year. Converting Adobe, Autodesk takes years, like 2, 3, 4, 5 years to convert that successfully over to Linux in a really good, stable, good manner. And at that time, like I said, traditional computing is not what it is today. So I don't think Linux will ever beat Mac OS. What does that mean for Windows? It will never beat Windows. Never. I don't think Linux is ever going to beat Windows. The only thing that's going to beat Windows Windows is another Windows, meaning like either Microsoft make another Windows, meaning like it's based on, it could be Linux based, who knows? Craziest thing has happened in this world. It could be based on a totally different operating system. They could make their own new version of Windows, new kernel architecture. It could be Windows ARM that replaced Windows x86 or something like that. It's just never going to happen. At best, we probably will see like about a third of each. So Windows will have about a third, macOS will have about a third, and Linux will have about a third. That's like the best case scenario you can hope of. And that world I would love to live in, because that means that all three operating systems is as viable as each other. So that means that you're not bound by the operating system anymore, because all of the software and hardware that you want to run can be run on all systems. That's what about a third for each system means, is that there's no killer apps or apps that you can only do, or things you can only do on Windows, and the same with Linux and macOS, or the other way around. They are equal. That would be the perfect scenario. That is probably where everyone would be happy. Linux is not going to outcompete all operating systems. There's not going to be a world like this where there's only Linux. Never going to happen. There will always be Windows. Will, as long as there are operating systems, Windows will always exist. macOS will always exist. FreeBSD or Haiku and all those will always, or systems like those will always exist. You have to get that into your noggin. There will never be this world where Linux is like 100% and nothing ever happened. Never going to happen. Best case scenario is about a third-ish division between these three, which is what a lot of Linux users don't want to hear. But anyway, I see a lot of people using this unknown, where they're like, oh, we have to assume that because Linux is, you know, used in a lot of places, hidden behind a lot of walls and firewalls and hackers and all that shit, they may not publicize, you know, that they're using Linux. So actually, these 7.14%, 50% of that or all of them should be run over to Linux. Well, what if I said, like, well, I would say the same about, you know, Windows, that most of these unknowns are people pirating Windows, and then they are hiding it from, you know, Microsoft servers and stuff like that, so therefore they are masking that they're actually running Linux. Or sorry, Windows, because they don't want to be caught pirating and being good old fucking pirates on a pirate ship and, you know, patches on their eyes and wooden legs and running around and swinging their swords around on a Windows machine. What makes my assumption or your assumption better than each other? It's all an assumption. It's not driven by any data. This is probably the one that frustrates me the most about how stupid the Linux community is. Is that they don't want to see the fact what this is. So they're trying to combine these two here, these two with each other, because it makes it look better. Unknown means unknown. So that means that we can't assume or we can't guess, because that's not data, that's a feeling, that's an assumption, that's what I like it to be. Because I can assume that all 7% or 7.14% are all Windows. I can assume they're all macOS. Why is my assumption not as wide as yours? Because I can come up with the same arguments that you're doing for why it should be Linux. There's a lot of people using hybrid version of macOS and Windows and masquerading as other operating system, or they are using it from places where, or doing stuff with the operating system that is probably illegal, so they are not publicizing what operating system they are using, because then hackers may not look at it, or people may not try and attack them and stuff like that. There's many reasons why people are doing that, and I've seen a lot of them happen in real life, by the way. So what we should be doing is, this is the most fair way of doing it, and even though it may not be the most logical way, but it's the most fair way, is that you take these 7.14% and you divide them equally over all of these things. So out of so Windows, macOS, Linux, Chrome OS, and FreeBSD get an equal size of this here. That is the most fair way of doing it. Could you say that, well, Linux probably have a bigger part of this than all of the others? I can see a good debate about it. I can also see a good debate about FreeBSD may have a bigger part of this than Linux have. Maybe even Chrome OS. There's all good arguments for all of them. The fact is, we don't know. And here's the thing. I wish when they did these things, they would leave this out. Because unknown makes people speculate. And then they use speculations as fact because they want to make something better than this. That's a lot of really, really, really crazy fanboys, fangirls, aliens, whatever the fuck they are. They love to put this in with this because it makes it look better than it is. I don't give a fuck about markets here, to be honest. But I do care about being honest. I do care about being fair when we are representing data. Saying a big part of this is Linux, or all of this is Linux, is not fair, because we don't know. And that is why in a lot of statistic areas, I wish they would leave these unknown out, because a lot of people that don't know about statistics or how to read them, they would just say, oh, it's all Linux because, you know, maybe they are running a distribution they have built themselves. Yeah, but if they build it on Ubuntu or they build it on Debian, it will project Debian or Ubuntu into the world unless they do something in Linux that so it don't project that into the world. Or again, they can be using that Linux machine behind other systems, then masquerading what operating system they're using for security reasons, etc., etc. There's a lot of good reasons why this here, if you want to use it in a statistic like this, you equally divide it between all of these that we're taking statistic of. But this is more or less pointless. Again, look at this massive gap here. Like, I could float in here with my fat body and have a good time, have ample fucking wiggle room, and nobody would care. I keep saying this a lot. 4%, 5% of a market can be lost, like, overnight. Overnight. You know, what is it here? Like, so in a year, Windows have lost, well, 3 or 4, how much have they lost? Let's say 70... Almost Linux, Windows in a year has almost lost the same percent of market share that Linux have gained in 3 decades. That's how fragile a market is. If you put macOS in here, they have a little bit more wiggle room. Because look at like this, if Linux fucks, if one or two or three, like if Ubuntu fucks really massively up, that could mean the end of the Linux desktop. That means that the Linux desktop, like if they really fucking piss off the users of the Linux desktop, which is primarily Ubuntu users, by the way. If they fuck up, you know, their customers, if they really piss off their customers, that could mean that this went down to 1% or under 1% in a month or in a year. If Windows have like a, you know, they have done a lot of bad decisions. Let's not fool ourselves. And you see that here, you know, they have done a lot of bad decisions. Then they get up, they're good grade, they make more bad decisions. They get up in a good grade, they make more bad decisions. You see here, like in a few months here, they went from, well, they lost almost 2% of the market share in a few months. That would be like Linux can lose 50% of its market share in 2 months by making a shitty decision. This is why that if you are this small of a part of a market, you cannot fuck anything up. Because if you fuck something up, it could be the end of your product. And we have to look at the Linux desktop as a product, because that's what it is. It's a product that we want people to use. It's a product that you want other people to use. It's a product that you want to have a higher market share. It's really easy to lose 4%, 2%, 3%, 4% of a market in months. Again, we see that here, like from May to July. You know, it's I'm all exaggerating here. So it's almost 4% here. Yeah, it's like 1.5%. Oh wait, what? Am I getting too tired here? So about a little over 1%. So close to 2% in like, you know, a few months. Again, that will help the fucking go down to 2.20% if Ubuntu fucks off the mark. Let's just say Ubuntu Ubuntu just kill off the Ubuntu desktop. That will probably make Linux go down to like 3%, 2.5% overnight. 2.5%. Is what I'm guessing. I would be guessing probably half this. Let's say 2.20% if Ubuntu did that, if not more. Let's say 2% if you're being like, that's probably the worst case scenario, 2%. That can happen overnight. Ubuntu could just say, we don't give a fuck about the desktop anymore. Could the community fork it and all? Of course, but then it will take years before they start to build up that reputation again. That's how fragile this is. And there is no massive spike when Proton came to Linux. Linux was about 2.something%, 3.something%. It has done nothing. Steam has done nothing for the Linux. If you look at Linux over the this is just a year, but can I edit it from, so if we say, when the Proton came out, let's say 2020. There's January 2020. And we take, you can see the massive dip Windows had here. 77%, it got a massive dip here. And then it's going up again. But let's take Unknown away. Let's take Chrome OS. Let's take Dotted away. Look, Windows lost over the entire Linux market share in a month. March, April. That's how fragile this little thing here is. And when did the Steam Deck came out? Give me a second here. So 2022 here. So 4.19%. So this is not even the case, but let's just say the Steam Deck gave Linux 2.20% market share. It's not the case because you also have organic growth and stuff like that and blah, 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 blah. This is like... The Steam, because what should happen here is the Steam that came out about, I think it was February, so here about, you should see like a drastic increase. There's no drastic increase. The Steam Deck did nothing. What if you do this? What if you go all the way back to like, what is the longest you go back? 2009. See, macOS actually had a massive dip also. Not even 1% in 2009 and 4%. Windows have like, it is on a somewhat down, you know, downwards slope. What if you put the macOS into it? macOS is more or less on the up. Here's how I look at it. If I look at it like this, Linux is somewhat standing still. Somewhat. It's increasing a little bit. But macOS is actually growing a lot faster and better and more stable than Linux is. Windows is drastically falling in popularity. What we don't see here is this here, Android versions and iOS version. Can I add them? Oh, here, desktop, mobile, tablet, view charts. This is why Windows is falling and Android is rising. The fall of Windows is not because of macOS or Linux, it's because of Android and iOS. What did I say about more and more people are going over to tablets and mobiles? Why are everyone saying that this is the most explosive and fastest expanding market at the time? Because you can see it here. You know, you can see it here. What is really killing Windows is iOS and Android, not Linux desktop. The Linux desktop, the traditional Linux desktop with you know, like a case and all that fancy dancy shit that we have on our desk that is big and heavy and take a lot of fucking place, is dying. So is the Windows desktop. The macOS is more likely laptops. And that's also, you know, this here is probably primarily laptop use. 80 to 90% of these users here are using either MacBooks or Windows laptops. They're not using traditional Windows machines, even though there's a lot of gamers. But what is really killing Linux, or sorry, Windows, is not Linux desktop, it's handheld devices, because more and more people are using it. When I was a teenager, everyone had a big base fucking computer in their house. Now, when I go see all my friends and I help people and I go out talk to people, I see more of this and less of this. So more people are having tablets, phones in their houses than they're having laptops and traditional computers. And this is what Linux people don't tell you. They don't tell you this. What they do tell you is this. Look, we kind of groan a little bit. Like, let's just hope someone don't fucking fart in the wind and someone smells it and say Linux is a bad OS because of it. Let's hope there's no like massive fucking security breach that make Linux or that make Linux into be kind of like super insecure and stuff like that, that nobody wants to touch it, because that means the death of Linux. If there is a massive problem with Linux, the Linux desktop like Ubuntu, Red Hat and stuff like that, it could kill off the Linux desktop for the consumer. Because they are already going with this. If you look at it like this, the Linux growth is almost pointless. Like the Linux desktop growth. And again, Android is not Linux, it's a fork. Look, I made videos about this. There is more non-Linux code in the Android kernel than there is Linux code, okay? More. If you call Android for Linux, you should be calling macOS for FreeBSD. That's how it should be. You have to be consistent. Android is its own thing. It's based on Linux, I will give you that, but it's its own thing. Or else they will put Android under Linux, of course. But look, what is killing Windows is tablets and phone, not the Linux desktop. And that is why I keep telling people, Linux users are misleading you. They are lying to you. They're not giving you the straight facts. And they think that Linux is killing Windows. And macOS, no, Android is. And to some degree, iOS is killing fucking macOS. Like in 2013, iOS started to kill off macOS. Why do you think macOS is looking more and more like iOS? One day, they will be one. It will be the same, like Android or iOS will be macOS and macOS will be iOS. They will be one. And Apple already want people to move away from the iMacs and the MacBooks and go over to tablets. That's why they're doing States Manager and all that fucking shit. Android is doing the same with like Samsung DeX and these kind of technologies. This is the future, people. This is the future, not this. I hope this made sense for you. This is the reality. The reality is handheld devices are killing the traditional desktop. Handheld devices is killing traditional computing as we know it. Soon laptops, like desktops, like traditional desktops are already dead. It's only crazy people like you and me that are running them. Laptops is the next thing to go, because more and more people are using consoles for gaming and gaming on tablets and phones. That's why you see a lot of the public popular games have a mobile version of it. PC gaming is dying, PC desktoping is dying. That means the year of the Linux desktop is dying. That means that Windows is dying. That means that Mac OS is dying. What is not dying is handheld devices. I've been saying this ever since 2018, if not before this. You can see here that I'm not bullshitting you. Linux people are lying to you. They are lying. See you all later. Have a good day. Bye bye.